Everyone, welcome to the new video. So today Android Studio Electric Eel got released. So let's check out the updates. If you want, you can watch this video. We have improved compose preview updates automatically. Yeah, this was quite buggy in future versions of Android Studio. Sorry, in previous versions of Android Studio. Would definitely like to try it out. I hope it is more performant. Then there is a compose preview device pack available. Then layout inspector, recomposition, rendering highlights. Okay, so the layout inspector now highlights recomposition. This allows you to identify where in the application the most recent activity caused the highest change in recomposition counts. The UI elements with most recent changes are temporarily overlaid with a color. This makes it easy to track down unexpected or excessive recomposition happening in your app. So I wish this kind of feature was available in React.js or React Native. But if it is already available, do let me know in the comments below. I wish something like this should be available for Swift UI and Flutter as well. They have made some improvements in XML as well, visual linting for views. But I no longer use XML, so if you are interested, you can check it out. There is something called universal problems problem panel. This includes visual linting, navigation and compose related issues. Build dependency import synchronization performance with parallel project import, download impact and build analyzer, upgrade assistant, post upgrade report and rollback support, SDK index integration, base profile fix for app bundle, then all new locket, app quality insights window. Then locket was already available in the previous version of Android Studio as well. It was just that it was an experimental phase. I think now it has got stable. App quality insight window lets you browse and investigate crash data from directly in Android Studio without, like, I am not sure whether this was really necessary or not. Features like this really slow down the IDE. I wish this kind of features were optional, just so that whoever wants it will install it. And I wish they were not directly part of the IDE. But any which ways. The new desktop category and desktop AVD. Resizable emulator. It is an experimental feature. Physical device mirroring experimental. Okay. You can mirror your own physical device to Android Studio. Oh, nice. This is a nice feature. Like, macOS and iOS already has this feature, but given that they belong to the same company, it might have been easier for them to implement. And this could have been really challenging for Google team to implement this kind of a feature inside an app, whereas Apple had the whole, you know, OS ecosystem to implement that kind of a feature. So yeah, I'm really looking forward to this physical device mirroring, because would be easy for me to share my screen and let my QA or team lead discuss what exactly is happening on a real device instead of showing it on an emulator. Yeah, this is just a recap. So you can download Android Studio Electric today. Thank you for watching. See you in the next one.